Those responsible for the refurbishment of Grenfell Tower in London are now considered suspects of corporate manslaughter and could be charged over the deaths of more than 80 people killed in the blaze. Here, there are more than 1,000 buildings across the state deemed a fire risk, with cladding that could burn quickly.
It's rife across Sydney, in the suburbs from the west through the city to the coast.
We've identified 1,011 buildings that may have cladding. Now, it's important to remember that not all cladding is bad.
But some is deadly, such as London's Grenfell Tower. Its aluminium covering burned.
The Grenfell disaster happened in July. We moved straight away. We're implementing the strongest fire safety reforms in the country.
They include new rules to stop the use of dangerous building products, a government task force to manage the reforms, and an audit of all government buildings for cladding, focusing on social housing.
We want to focus primarily on prevention first, so stopping a fire from occurring in any building is primary to us.
Owners of suspect buildings will be contacted and fire and rescue officers will visit each one.
The owners of any building found to have dangerous cladding will be forced to tear it down, a potentially expensive exercise that the government says it won't pay for.
It's going to be mums and dads that are going to foot the bill, not the dodgy developers who have used dodgy products. They're going to get off scot-free.
In London, police have informed owners of Grenfell Tower they may have committed corporate manslaughter. Sean Berry, 7 News.